mathematical thinking is extremely important in problem solving, not only in maths domain but also in many other spheres of social life.
In order to be able to go from the world of children to, for example, to go to the abstract world of mathematics, it is not a simple, smooth journey. It's a journey in which children need to be guided with a very carefully thought out kind of a trajectory.
From what I understand, Mehboob is a child who used to go regularly to school, at least till class 3. Then his parents found that he didn't really know anything. They found that he was, you know, working, doing properly, he was copying. But in order to be able to say or to give the answers to questions, etc., which was expected, they was not doing. So then afterwards, he was promoted to class 4. And then to 5, and in class 5, because there is board exam, other things, the teacher suggested that he cannot continue. But just imagine for a child like him to be in class 5, what a torture it must be, you know.
Plus 2 by 6.
We have come across so many children like Mehboob who go to school and even after 3 or 5 years do not even have the minimal competencies.
Again, हम उसी पूरी प्रोसेस को रिपीट करते हैं, which is equals to इन दोनों में से आपने कॉमन क्या लिया? Six. Clear? आपने ज्योमेट्री में क्या?
This is not the school where Mehboob studied. Mehboob studied in a government school in Motibagh.
Plus two. Next step.
But in one sense, if you look at most of the schools in Delhi. The teaching is more or less same, whether it is private school, whether it is government school. A teacher will come, she will using the board and chalk and continuously lecturing, making it sure that every child is listening to her, seeing her and writing the notes. So whether they agree it or not, their practices clearly says this is the philosophy within which they have. So how to change that particular view is the task of judoka.
Jodogyan Kendra is a demonstration model, you can say, a place where you can say, look, our children can learn differently. That our children can actually learn and be very competent, whether it's in mathematics or in science or any other subjects. So if you feel that this is good, let's talk about how can this happen with more children.
Mehboob has been with us only for a couple of weeks, but the little I have seen of him makes me feel that given the opportunity, he would be able to learn and achieve the kind of levels which we expect him to have by the time when he's 15 or 16. Actually, his sister Sitara, who came to us about 3 years ago, was also in a similar kind of a situation. She was at that time in class 2, but she was already about 11 years old. And she knew a little bit, but not what anybody would feel should be according to her age. And of course, it took a little time. I'm not saying she doesn't have difficulties, as it, but she is now very much into learning. She reads books, she enjoys reading, she asks a lot of questions, thinks about things. And she's become really a learner who's curious about the world. We think that what happened with Sitara maybe can happen with Mehboob also.
सबसे पहले मैं टीचर बनूंगी, उसके बाद मैं डॉक्टर बनना चाहती हूँ।
पापा के साथ जाकर वहाँ कपड़ा दिया करूँगा पापा को, पापा सिल दे करेंगे, मैं जिस जिसे कपड़ा देंगे वो दिया करूँगा।
वो तो बहुत कुछ बोलते हैं, मुझे ये करना है वो करना है। अब उससे पूछेंगे तो बेचारा कुछ ज़्यादा नहीं, क्योंकि उसने बोला कि मैं भी पापा की तरह सिलाई करूँगा, तो जो उसके पास है उसी हिसाब से उसने अपने सपने भी सिकोड़ कर रखा हुआ है।
शादियों में तो बहुत डांस करता है, मना करो फिर भी शादियों में डांस ज़रूर करना है।
मुझे अच्छा लगता है डांस करने में।
हमारे बच्चों को जब पढ़ना आता है तो किताब की दुनिया में ही उन्होंने उड़ना भी है, जो कुछ भी देखा, एरोप्लेन कैसे बना रहे हैं, कि डॉक्टर बनने से क्या होगा या टीचर बनने से क्या होगा, तो बच्चे भी बताए, तो वो चीज़ें देख ही नहीं पाया ना। एक साल बाद शायद उसकी बिल्कुल, जब हम पूछेंगे अब क्या बनोगे, तो शायद वो बहुत कुछ बोल पाएगा, उम्मीद है हमें।
In what we have seen, I think his attitude towards mathematics is good. Seems to be bright. Doesn't seem as if he has any learning disability. But what happened earlier, I think it's happening to many, many children in our schools. I think we are not thinking about children often when we teach, no? We think of completing this lesson. We think of, completing the syllabus. And that is often done by you write on the blackboard and children copy it. And such things, maybe with some support from home or extra, etc., maybe some children are able to manage. But without any help in that sense, maybe other children are not able to.
Learning is not an individual activity. There is a meeting of minds in that learning process.
There is a more knowledgeable person and a less knowledgeable person. It's a joint activity between the two of them. You are looking at one thing, you establish a common meaning, and you have this feeling that the other person also understands it the same way as you understand.
And then the child, learns to think in a particular way, reason in a particular way, and then afterwards it becomes part of its own inner self.
Teacher is very, very important. Teacher should take children to a level which children cannot reach alone.
इसमें ना इल्ली की दो, एक बुरे लड़की और एक खरी लड़की. इसके बाद चार दो.
So looking at children, seeing how they experience, how they think, then designing the activity or conversation is very, very powerful.
I think children are very much attuned to people. The role of emotion, that is something which is the most important aspect for their lives, as I understand it. And of course, they are also very much affected by the immediate context. And that's why now stories play such a major role in whatever we do.
अच्छा, एक लड़की है जिसका नाम हम रखेंगे तो नुसरत के घर में कहाँ से मेहमान आए थे, किया उन्होंने काफी सारे लड्डू, बेसन की लड्डू लेकर आए थे।
It is a meaningful, understandable situation to them. There is a problem they can identify, they can think about.
Dadi,
मैं लड्डू खाऊं एंड देन वी फाइंड दैट द रिस्पांस ऑफ चिल्ड्रन इज सो डिफरेंट.
पापा को कितने लड्डू दे देंगे?
And then you go through a slow process of disengaging from that meaningful, emotion-laden context to a very thin kind of a context, and then slowly again into pure numbers.
Zero. Zero. Khatam.
Maybe I think the best thing which Jodo Gyan did in Delhi and many parts of our country is popularizing Ganit Mala as a tool for teaching numbers, additions, and few other operations. Ganit Mala can be translated as garlands of numbers.
The beauty of the Ganit Mala is that you can, you know, a child can start interacting by just by counting.
42, 43, 44, 45.
Almost naturally, implicitly, they start seeing the structure.
50.
When you write, say, 28. And you say this is 2 tens and this is 8 ones, you are asking the children to think analytically. 28 is not being seen as just a 28, you are seeing analysis as 2 tens, 8 ones. And I think that is too difficult for a children of that age. They need to get to become familiar with something and then you can start analyzing. It's not only for children, even for us. It's, you know, you need some amount of familiarity with something before you can start looking at it analytically. So the Ganit Mala gives you the opportunity to count, to become familiar with numbers, and then you start seeing, okay, 28, that is 20, and then there is 8 which comes before.
80.
If you look at 80s onwards, teaching aid was a very familiar idea that in order to teach, you need a material which will explain what is A plus B whole square. So there, the whole idea is to make children understand what is written in the textbook. It basically is demonstration. So now, from demonstration method, we are popularizing meaningful transactions and creation of an environment where you provide some teaching learning material with some stories and context. You create a kind of activity within which children are learning.
He may not be able to read and write, but Mehboob already has a number sense. He is not like a 5-year-old who does not know 20 is more or 15 is less. He has a number sense, 100 plus somewhere. But it is not linked with the notation which we use, the written numbers. So his number sense is apparently something which he has picked up in daily life, in the street. He manages to go beyond 100 or even up to 200 or beyond by making patterns of 100 and then doing that. But all that shows a certain level of intelligence. But he still needs to learn all the numbers properly. He has a sense of idea what is that quantity which he says, but the standard format of naming it is not comfortable.
Whatever you do, children make mistakes in the area of place value. Generally, even when we do workshop, what is mathematics? Most of the teachers give this idea, it is operations, some geometry.
See, this is the classic idea. Now, to do operations, the basic requirement is a clear understanding of place value. Not understanding, to operate on the basis of place value. So, the whole enterprises in grade 1 and 2 is designed in order to teach place value. And they think if they understand place value, operations are going to be easy and their maths are going to be very, very easy. So, the whole idea of what is mathematics is very narrow. 10, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36. So that's why Jodogyan, when we start with one program, place value. The difference is we start numbers within the real world to understand the world of numbers and connecting that again to the real world.
43.
Gradually, they arrive at place value as an efficient strategy in order to do additions and subtractions. But they can do additions and subtractions without place value.
26. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
Usha always insisted Ganitmala and related activities in order to strengthen, deepen number sense so that they understand and they are able to do additions and subtractions.
31. So, 31
mein lagana hai.
When teachers saw that is happening, then there was a realization, sir, so far we were putting so much effort on teaching place value, UTH, abacus, Dean's block, and still it is not working. But this way children are able to do addition and subtraction with more ease.
41.
Learning can be meaningful, joyful, this is possible, but still many parts of our India, many teachers do believe that education means a child sitting like this, listening and taking note, and again and again reading it, again and again writing it. That is the way one learns. There are solutions to those problems related with maths education, which should be available and accessible to most of the schools in our country.
I think Mehboob is progressing quite nicely. He still has problems with all the number names, but I think he has made a considerable progress. He seems to enjoy working with numbers. That's why today when we asked a question which is actually way beyond what he's doing, that is taking different compositions of 200, it's not only that he did many of them correctly, but he was so engrossed in it. So I think he's enjoying it, and it's quite very encouraging, I must say. I feel good. What I'm worried about is whether he will continue to come.
to our school, because if he comes consistently to school, I think in 2-3 years from now, he would be able to achieve the kind of levels which we expect him to have by the time when he's 15 or 16.
But time will tell, let us see.
अभी तो कुछ नहीं है कि गेम वो देख रहा है हर तरीके का, जो भी पढ़ाई है उसको भी वो गेम के तरह ही देख रहा है। कम से कम जब उसको पढ़ने का शौक जब होगा कि मुझे पढ़ना है।
As I see it, the goal of education is to bring in the new generation to become full, confident members of our human community.
Somewhere we are also talking about mathematics, which is a very powerful tool. I think this is a heritage which we as human beings have inherited out of thousands of years of human endeavor across the world. And it's a birthright of every child to be given access to that, you know. It's also that aspect of it, to know the beauty of it. I think there are quite a lot of people who are becoming aware of the fact that if something has to change in our country, it has to happen in education.
Such a big country with very complex problems. It is so difficult for one organization to come up and say that this can be done. Rather, we need hundreds of organizations. Few can be like Jodogyan, few can be like Eklavya or Digandar or Navnirmiti. There should be so many organizations. We want to be part of one among them.
इसलिए मेरा मतलब था लाने का स्कूल में कि ये अच्छी तरह पढ़ाई करना और अच्छी तरह बात करना सबसे बड़ों से अच्छी तरह सीखे, क्योंकि मैंने भी स्कूल में आके सब कुछ अच्छा सीखा, इसलिए मैं चाहती हूँ कि मेरा भाई है वो भी अच्छी चीज़ें सीखे।
आंखें बंद तो डब्बा गुल, ओए बंद दरवाजे खोल रे, ओ जा बिंदास बोल रे, मैं भी हूँ तू भी है, ओ मैं भी तू भी, हम सब मिलके बम चिक बम 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 ऐसी रंगों भरी अपनी दुनिया है क्यों, सोचो तो सोचो ना, प्यार से चुनके इन रंगों को।